Hello, and welcome to your technique video for the Binary Chemical Reactions Lab. Numerous chemicals will be used in the lab today, so make sure that you keep your goggles on at all times. If any of the solutions get spilled on your skin, you need to flush the area thoroughly. When you are finished and start to clean up, you can pour any of the liquid solutions down the sink. However, any solid metals need to go in the solid waste container located in the hood. Do not pour the zinc down the sink. This will cause the sink to become clogged and you'll make your TAs angry. We've made this handy limerick to help you remember this. There once was a student named Link who loved the princess in pink. She's destined to reside far across the divide because you put zinc in the sink. You can't forget now, can you? If you didn't get this reference, you probably did not grow up with a Nintendo. The pH paper can be thrown away in the normal trash can. During exercise 1, you will be mixing known solutions together to see what happens. You will need some zinc, a set of the solutions, a pair of tweezers, a well plate, a toothpick, and some pH paper. After you have made your observations, you will use that data in exercise 2 to identify several unknown solutions. You will be doing all of your mixing in a well plate. You should only need a few drops of reagent. The wells in the well plate are pretty small, so you won't have room for much solution anyways. You can use your toothpick to stir your solutions if you want. We're not going to show you all of the combinations in this video because that would ruin the surprise, so we'll give you a few tips to make your lab go smoothly. Sometimes the bubbles or precipitate particles are small and hard to see, especially against the black background of your lab bench. If you move the well plate to a blank white page of your notebook, you may have an easier time seeing your results. To test the pH, you can rip up some pH paper, then place a drop of each of the solutions on it. Compare the color of the paper to the color of the key to estimate the pH. Use the tweezers to place the zinc into the well and to remove the zinc from the well plate when you clean up. As you move through the experiments, keep track of your observations using a simple chart like this one. Make sure you leave some space to write down legible, detailed notes. To save space, you could add abbreviations like NVC for no visible change, as long as you write down a quick key for what they mean. To help you stay organized and work faster, you can match your well plate to a section of your data table. Many of the well plates are 6x4 wells, so you can take a 6x4 part of your table and mix the corresponding solutions. You can use your completed chart when you go to identify the unknowns. Make sure that you also record your observations for any tests that you use on your unknowns and include the ID number that is on the bottle. All right, that's the end of our video. Remember to read your lab manual and good luck on your quiz.